Cineverite examples, BBC News interviews. These documentaries and interviews demonstrate cinema verite, as in their shots you can see some filming equipment. For example, in a BBC interview, you often see a shot at the start of an interview that includes all of the recording and sound equipment and the whole setup of the filming. The use of cinema verite attempts to break the illusion of the film world to the audience so that they understand that the product they are viewing has been set up. It is a form of hyperrealism, as any footage used, such as shots of dancers, is very plain and raw without any dramatic or cinematic flair. There will be no extensive use of lighting, as any extra lighting would make the shots more cinematic. Therefore, anything filmed in the cinema verite style would only use natural lighting in order to make it as realistic as possible. This is extremely different to how we filmed our documentary, as we used the extra lighting for all of our interviews and the majority of our shots. This is what helped us to create our cinematic style, as the lighting created a theatrical tone within the cinematography. Cinema verite is more suited to a sophisticated audience, as they don't need cinematic shots to help illustrate the content to them. They can understand the message without there being need to emphasise it or illustrate it. Furthermore, they often don't need the cinematic element to keep them interested in watching the documentary or interview, as the content is enough to keep their attention. This is because a sophisticated audience are well educated and are part of the self-actualisation section of Maslow's hierarchy of needs. This means that through watching the documentary, they are wanting to learn and fill their needs of problem solving and creativity. So, the sophisticated audience are more likely to pay attention to the actual content of the documentary rather than how it looks, meaning cinema verite is more suited towards a sophisticated audience.
Our audience are 18 to 25, so are not too sophisticated. Also, due to our emphasis upon story, we chose a cinematic style, as this helps to illustrate our narrative to the audience more efficiently. This is clearly shown during the ending montage, where we have used same actors throughout to create the idea of a build-up to a performance. This type of cinematic style and narrative helps to create an emotional tone within our documentary, and therefore inspires our audience to a greater effect. Also, because they are watching two people going through the process before a performance, they can also imagine themselves in the same situation. The cinematic style also emphasises the theme of theatre and show business. This is due to the lighting and the cinematography not being very realistic. This connotes that the theatre industry is another world for a lot of people, as many don't know what goes on behind the show business facade. Therefore, the lighting that we use emphasises the common perception of the theatre being dramatic.
Overall, the two styles are very different. However, due to the content of our documentary and the story, it was the cinematic style that was the best choice for our production.
It was spelled wrong.
Do you know what that word just reminds me of? The play that goes wrong. Amir!
Facade!
As many don't know what goes on behind its show business facade.
Facade!
Isn't it? So it's facade.
Facade. I said
facade. As many don't know what goes on behind the show business facade. As many don't know what goes on behind the show business facade.
What is it?
Show business facade.
Facade. Okay.